Welcome back to the final round, to the climax of the British Offshore Powerboat Grand Prix series. It's in Southampton Water, and your commentator there is Peter Butler.
Welcome to Southampton and the Global Group Grand Prix Offshore Powerboat Series. I'm Peter Butler, and you'll be joining me for more action in the final race of this spectacular series. After 500 miles, it's down to the last round. And in rainy conditions, all eyes are in the skies, hoping for a break in the weather. Some of Europe's most powerful offshore powerboats, ranging from 1.3 litre all the way up to 16 litre, and the 2,000 horsepower giants of class 1 and 2. Everyone in a state of nervous anticipation, none more so than the Follett team, who, after a great start to the series, have been dogged with mechanical problems and the unreliability of the engines. For Richard Lawson, it's a problem. Just one chance, and one chance only, in today's race to pull off victory in this championship. But he still leads by 4 points. Behind him, Dave Allenby in Mariner, Miles Jennings in Brute, and Chris Scragg in Kent Coy, all on 27 points. John Craxford, the throttleman, looks anxiously at the engines that have given them so many problems. Primarily, it has been failure of the turbochargers on the big diesel engines, but now they face an additional handicap.
We've got a problem in the box section of the back of the boat. The tube has apparently collapsed in there, and that's a major rebuild to get it right, which means we can't pump air down onto the propellers to get it onto the plane. So the only way to get on the plane is to go round in circles, one way to get one engine up, and then round the other way to get the other one up.
You get the propeller to cavitate.
Yeah, so
we'll be there.
With a bit of luck, we'll be there, and with a bit of luck, we'll be there at the end. We're going to try.
And another man with engine problems is John Baker in Flipping Eck. He has an outside chance of winning the championship. But what of the other three main contenders?
Everybody's in with a chance of winning the big trophy. I think in our case, we've got to beat everybody. And just fingers crossed that we can do it. If the boat runs like it did at Bournemouth in the last race, if the throttle cables don't fall off, we ought to be able to do it. So we're quietly confident, as always.
It's very, very close on the points. It's going to be a tough one. There's a big low out there, and we're hoping that it's going to blow in. This could be the lull before the storm. Who knows? The wind gets up, we're in with a chance. We want it to be as rough as anything out there. If it's really, really rough, then we hope that we can win purely on trying that much harder than everybody else.
Towards the end of the race, I think, as long as the conditions permit, we should be running close to 100, certainly. We had a test run yesterday with all the fuel on board, and we weren't getting anything like that. So the idea is to stay out in as close to the front as we can, and then use the speed that we've got at the end of the race.
In 4 litre, 1 point separates Jeff Purves from this man, Mike Manning, in Blyline.
We've got a fuel problem. There's fuel leaking inside the engine, so it's a matter of a quick strip down and hope we can cure it. Should be okay.
I think we're faster than Mike, so we're going to stay behind him, but within contention all the time, and hope on the last lap overtake him. That's the theory, and put all the pressure on Mike. I think it's going to be calm in the Southampton Water, and then a bit choppy as we go into the Solent to get the Red Funnel Ferry coming in. That always presents a problem. Not quite sure how big the wake is. If you're running flat out and hit it without seeing it, you can take off. It's just like going up a ski ramp, and you're in the lap of the gods. Which way up you're going to land on the other side?
And as the breeze picks up, conditions are far from ideal. With the rain reducing visibility considerably, it will be far from easy on the outward leg, which takes them into the Solent, then six times around the triangular lap before they make their way back on the inward leg to the finish. Some people, it seems, are always happy singing and dancing in the rain. But for the crews making their way to the start, it is far from a laughing matter. Rain and mist at over 80 miles per hour must be taken very seriously indeed. And here, at the start in class 1 and 2, in production, the yellow flag is up as they await the start down the Solent. Miles Jennings, the yellow boat M44 on this side, just inside him, the distinctive decals of Kent Coy. And as the green flag goes up, it's Miles Jennings who flies away from the start. M100 phase one alongside 72 Mariner UK, but the man in front making the running, M44, Miles Jennings and Ed Williams-Hawke, determined to lay their hands on the trophy. But it's not going to be easy, because in the flat water, the catamaran M72 and the catamaran of John Fay M100 begin to get lift and go past Miles Jennings. Follett, in spite of the problems, are underway, but the problems of John Baker mount, and he is temporarily out of this race. And as they turn in the Solent on the first mark towards the Isle of Wight, it's number M72, Mariner UK, David and Chris Allenby from Poole, who lead overall. Behind them and in second position, it's phase one, M100, John Fay and John Hampton. Third, Miles Jennings and Ed Williams-Hawke. Remember, of course, they have to win today. And so now the pressure is very, very much on them. In fourth position, M12, Kent Coy. And there in fifth position after a slow start, but they told us they had problems, problems they've had, but they're fifth and fighting the Follett group. 75, Richard Lawson and John Craxford. Still at the front, it's still 72, it's still Mariner UK that lead. Again, the flat water, very much to their liking. John Fay holds on to second position. And the crew from Surrey in the 27-foot Cougar Cat approach 90 miles per hour and have a clean break on this man with the disadvantage of the monohull. M44, the 29-foot Phantom, will not like the smooth conditions. So John Fay then makes the mark in second position. And Miles Jennings, for the moment, and I'm sure it is just for the moment, in third, but fighting. Follett comes through, passes Kent Coy into fourth position overall. Chris Scragg on the inside gets very close indeed to the wash of Richard Lawson there. That was a little too close for comfort. Richard Grant looks around, but they will now try and try desperately to hang on to Follett, but the superior power in the 41-foot shed design monohull, the 1600 horsepower of turbocharged diesel engines, should take them away from M12 and Chris Scragg. But we go back for the second start, and it's 4 litre, 2 litre and 1.3 litre. And as the flag goes up, they go away on the side, the yellow boat, D16 of Mike Manning. He's just 1 point, of course, behind the man who now leads this race. That is Jeff Purves in D6 Hospitality Inn. Mike Manning, of course, won the first race in this series at Swansea. It was his first ever championship win. How dearly he would like to add the championship to that. Behind them, the 2 litre fleet are gathered. In front, Nigel Cutler in Selcon Knauf. Behind him, on the left, Neil Bassett from London in R&R Motors. On the right, Peter Lister, the new European champion. And as the conditions begin to roughen, we will see, I'm sure, the monohulls pull away from the Cats. But here, a very, very sad sight indeed. It is the end of the season for M4, for Flippenek, and for John Baker. His valiant attempts all doomed to failure in this race. But back with 4 litre, and ahead still D6 Hospitality Inn, SGL Jet and Les Salvage in second, but going through and sandwiching him on the outside, Richard Stratton and Markham Weeks on his left. But there, clearly, the monohull of Peter Lister begins, as we said, to take the advantage, and you can see that there's very little Nigel Cutler can do about that. But the 4-litre fleet now beginning to bounce their way down through Southampton water, through the spectator boats. Richard Stratton there held up momentarily. Bitterly disappointed, of course, last week, leading, and then a disastrous error on the last lap cost him a victory. He was very annoyed about that, but so very determined when he came here this weekend that he would make amends. And there he goes. He threw and passed Ian Williams in Aqua Cultura. He will soon, I'm sure, get past the boat in third position, and indeed he has. Markham Weeks in just add water and tucked himself behind the leader, D6 Hospitality Inn. And back at the front, and it's the end of lap one. And David and Chris Allenby in M72 still lead. Tucked closely behind them, it's M100, phase one. John Hampton and John Fay making the most of the flat conditions. And up into third position, and they'll be very happy about that. The monohull, number 75, Richard Lawson and Dron Craxford are coming through the field. Miles Jennings can do absolutely nothing about this. Content at the moment with fourth place overall. And fifth for Kent Coy. They too, in the monohull, must await their time. And Pollitt now looking a different boat than it did at the start of this race, beginning to find some of the power that we know they've got. And so they now try to outmaneuver John Fay in phase one. Much more power, of course, come through on the inside. Try and find the gap. But there's no gap there. Miles Jennings and M44 still holds on. And now Richard Lawson finds the way through. Turns on the power, reaches somewhere over 90 miles per hour, goes past M100, and now attacks the lead. Miles Jennings also comes alongside M100, so maybe problems for John Fay. Bollett is through on that mark. John Fay is through, and Miles Jennings cuts through. Good mark for Miles Jennings. The superior handling of the monohull on that mark. He made it pay and took a very, very tight turn indeed. Good driving by Miles Jennings. Chris Scragg, much wider, still content to hold on. But back to the 4-litre duel, and it's still Jeff Purves in Hospitality in D6, who holds off, and now a flying Richard Stratton. Richard Stratton has got clear of the other boats in the pack and comes alongside Jeff Purves. And Richard Stratton then turning on the power, but Jeff Purves is slowing down. Now, there could be a problem with the boat of Jeff Purves, because Richard Stratton made it look awfully easy. Jeff Purves then, yes, now, visibly slowing down. There's a problem with D6, and the 25-foot Hicks Cat, Markham Weeks, in just add water, goes through into second position. And there you can see on the outside, Ian Williams in Aqua Cultura goes through into third position. And still slowing down, Jeff Purves, D6 Hospitality Inn. And Mike Manning will see Jeff Purves now and know that he is in fourth position. And if Jeff Purves cannot get the boat going again, then Mike Manning will win this championship. So Jeff Purves it is who disconnects his jack plug, goes to the engine to see if he can get going again. Meanwhile, at the end of lap one, it's Richard Stratton who leads. Number 41, Obsession, the boat of Richard Martindale in Production Cruiser, just ahead of the man in second position now in 4-litre. D19, just had water, Markham Weeks. And now the battle for 2-litre. And Jonathan Lucas has a most unlikely opponent. It is number 47, Paul Denford in the Joker. hanging on to third. The Cat, which way now? 43, and Mike Shepherd. And back at the front, Follett, of course, in second position when we last left. Now, way down on power, but no orange flag flying. Have they retired? There's an awful lot of smoke at the back, but the life jackets are coming off. And the conversation, no doubt, that they've had many times this season, and the same conclusion. But on this occasion, it's Mariner who takes advantage of the demise of Follett. And so David and Chris Allenby, yet again, as they did last week, find themselves in the lead and within touch of an overall victory. And of course, that would mean overall victory in this championship. Behind them, phase one, John Fay and M100. Still could spoil the party for this man, M44, Miles Jennings and Brute. But still, with his co-driver, Ed Williams-Hawke, they hang on, if but by a very thin thread. Kent Coy behind them, N12 for Chris Scragg. Not their conditions, but they will not relent. And production, and very, very tight at the head of the production class as Peter Armstrong comes through on the inside of 33, Will Haycock in Ambassador Communications. But Will Haycock's having none of that. They do battle again, as they did in Swansea, neck and neck. P7, Raven Estates and Stuart Raven in third position in the production class make the same mark. John Menetri, P67, Men Man leads Cruiser A. And at the end of the second lap in 2 litre, C47, the Joker, Paul Denford, has got away from Jonathan Lucas. Sandwiched between them, C43, which way now? Mike Shepherd in second position. And there, Jonathan Lucas, content with third, knowing he only has to finish in the top four to win this championship. In the 1.3-litre class, it's Sweden who leads, B7 and Max Hemmerstedt. Behind them, B27, Peter Little and David Arthur from Oxford. And in third position, the man who is still hot favourite for this championship, with his co-driver, Jeff Bird, it's Alan Layton in B40. And now we rejoin the race with just two laps to go. And still, it's M72, Mariner, Chris and David Allenby in the 36-foot right Cat that lead phase one. M100, John Fay and John Hampton. And they are having a torrid time behind the big 36-foot right Cat. Behind them, it's still Miles Jennings, M44, who makes a bid. It's his last chance, and he knows it. They've waited patiently. They can wait no longer. Takes to the outside and begins to catch phase one. John Fay looks around for impending danger. It's there all right, because Miles Jennings gets closer and closer. And there he is, and as Ed Williams-Hawke wipes the rain from his visor, it's an indication of just exactly how difficult conditions are getting. But Miles Jennings knows only too well that this is the time to go for victory. And so it's on to the last lap for Mariner UK. It's on to the last lap for phase 100 in second position, and just 100 yards behind in third position, Root and M44, Miles Jennings. Locked in battle, they are locked in the championship. Behind them, Chris Scragg and Richard Grant in Kent Coy. Still there, their presence not felt, but known. And now M44 slows down and Kent Coy goes through. And it's a disaster from the team from Devon, just when they were about to launch the final assault on this race in this championship. The boat slowed dramatically. Ed Williams-Hawke is now under the dash. Miles Jennings lends an ear. It will either be an electric problem or steering, but a quick wave of the feet there may indicate they may have found it. But there's renewed hope for Richard Grant and Chris Scragg in M12. And yes, Ed Williams-Hawks had found the problem, and they're away again, M44. But surely now it's too late. They've got to get past M12, the 39-foot Hunton of Chris Scragg. They are under full power now, heading up towards 70 or 80 miles per hour. They've got to catch this man, John Fay, in M100 with John Hampton. But look how the gap has closed. M12, Kent Coy, now have a second position well in sight. And back and heading for home on the last lap now. And it will be Mariner Magazine. And in front of them, the smaller boats covering today, of course, a shorter distance. We're with 4 litre, we're with D32, and that's Richard Stratton who leads. Richard Stratton with his co-driver, Paul Hicks, have driven to the maximum today. They have absolutely turned on the power. This is Blyline Mike Manning. He's done enough to win the championship. This is Will Haycock, 33. And he too has got ahead of Peter Armstrong. Peter Armstrong, of course, who led the championship this morning, is there in second position, will take the championship. But on the day, it was Will Haycock who crossed the line first. And so we're back with the lead, and they're celebrating already. They're on the home straight. M72, Chris and David Allenby. Nobody but nobody is going to stop them now. And in the background, you can see that M12, Chris Scragg, is coming alongside M100 Phase 1. This is David Graham-Smith in P4 in the production cruiser. And there, Phase 1 slowing down. A problem, I would say, as M12 makes ground once again on them, goes past and into second position. But no denying the men who have won today. David and Chris Allenby there in second position. Kent Coy, M12, they will be delighted in one respect, but so very, very disappointed in another. They played the waiting game, but perhaps waited too long. And there, M100, John Fay, disappointed, I'm sure. It's a second position for Kent Coy, third them for M100, Phase 1. And behind them, M44, that will be Brute, Miles Jennings, Ed Williams-Hawk. Disappointment, I'm sure, for them too. And the scoreboard tells the final story. In third position, Richard Lawson on 31 points. Looked so much a winner at the beginning of the series. Chris Scragg came through in the end into second position with 39 points. But that leaves the cousins from Paul to finally lift the Prince's Youth Business Trust trophy.
On the most easterly turn mark, that gave us our first opportunity to see what was behind us. And
there must have been a couple of miles behind then.
Yeah, we saw a couple of boats and recognised them and realised that we'd got a pretty good lead already. But after, I think about 10 minutes after that, I didn't know personally if we were going north, south, east or west. I was just getting the instruction. Left a bit, fire, that was it.
So a great end to a great series. We hope you enjoyed it. We look forward to 1991. Meanwhile, from me, Peter Butler, it's goodbye as we leave you with the results of the last race in the Global Group Series.
And our thanks to Peter Butler for his commentary through what's been a very exciting series.